I'm really excited about sharing this with you today. Thank you. Good morning. Thank you for joining us. But I'm excited to discuss this with you today, this devotion. And I've entitled it this, You Decide the Ending. You Decide the Ending. And let me give you a scripture in 2 Corinthians 5:9. So whether we are here in this body or away from this body, our goal is to please Him. I think I love that right there. You'll know this, Marcia. Henry Wadsworth Longfellow wrote this right here. Great is the art of beginning, but greater is the art of ending.
Praise God.
I like that. It's not how we begin.
It's how we end.
It's how we end, isn't it? You know, and the good news, Marcia, we get to choose our ending.
I think that's so awesome. I agree.
That God doesn't choose for us. The devil doesn't choose for us. Other people don't choose for us. We have that right to be able to do that. Yes. There's a story in the Bible about a guy who started off awesomely and had a bad ending. Mm-hmm. And his name's Samson. Mm-hmm. And Samson's one of the judges. If you go to the book of Judges, you'll read this. And in that book, it talks about Samson and how Samson was a man used of God, greatly used of God. But he put himself in a situation to where he allowed the enemy to trick him and to deceive him and literally wound up with a tragic ending.
He actually allowed pride to get in.
Yes, he did. He did.
Pride got in his way.
You know, one day, Marcia, I wrote this down. One day our life will be summed up in a paragraph on a program that will be handed out at our memorial service. When that day comes, no one will care how high you climbed in your profession. No one will care what kind of car you drove, not even a Cadillac, or how much money you made. Rather, they will talk about the kind of person that you are. You know, we do celebrations of people's lives, and one of the things that we always ask is for people to stand and talk about that person. And I've yet to hear someone talk about the house this person lived in, or the cars, or the clothes, or even their money, but they talked about the person. Amen. And I believe.
What's the story you told not too long ago in church? There's this man, he was so mean. Nobody liked him in the town. I mean, he was horrible to everybody. But at his funeral, everybody walked by the casket and nobody could say anything nice about the man. But there was this one man that was just always positive, always giving a good word. And he stood there for a minute and he looked and he stood there a minute. Do you remember what man said?
I don't.
It was something like, he sure liked to eat or something, you know. It was not what a wonderful man this was or anything like that. But the whole town just went, he sure did like to eat. That's all they said.
That's all they could think of.
Yeah, that's the only nice thing he could say. So what if, I don't want people saying that about me. Sure liked to eat.
One thing about my wife, she's one of those interesting people who read obituaries.
Okay.
And obituaries are very important though, aren't they, Marcia? Mm-hmm. Because they're the last thing typically that's printed about a person's life. Well, how about this right here?
And usually your family's the one who writes it.
So you've
got to be careful you don't have somebody write it that's mad at you.
Well, how about you write your own obituary?
Yeah, I like that. If you know you're going, you need to write your own obituary.
You choose your ending. I love that scripture in Deuteronomy chapter 30 and verse 19. To sum it up, it says, you decide how your story will end spiritually. God said, I call heaven and earth as witnesses today against you. I have set before you life and death, blessing and cursing. Therefore, choose life that both you and your descendants may live. And I like the next verse because it's like God kind of leans over and he goes, choose life.
That's right.
Choose life, you know, because he wants you to have a good ending. Amen. You know, we love this life, but we're pilgrims. We're just passing through this life. Mm-hmm. There is an eternity that we're going to. And I want my ending to be much better than my beginning.
Amen.
Praise God. God wants you to have spiritual success. God wants you to touch this world. But if we self-destruct spiritually, that's not on God. That's on you. We need to understand that. Yeah. God will not choose your ending for you. You will choose your ending. People say, would God send somebody to hell? God never sends one person. If you go to hell, you go to hell because you choose that. If you go to heaven.
Is it Revelation that says their works do follow them into heaven?
Yes.
I want to leave this world with
a legacy
of touching people, caring about people,
loving
people,
and
that those people are touched and that will follow me.
Absolutely. Father, I thank you, Lord. You give us the choice of our ending. You give us the choice of how we will leave this world, whether we will be spiritually attuned to you or we will be doing our own thing. I thank you, Lord. I pray for each one today that you will help them, Father God, to not only start right, but Father God, when we end, we're right as well. In Jesus' name, amen.